Take a look at this police lineup. Can you find Frank? It's easy, just look for the beard. And you see, Frank, like hundreds of other people, was wrongfully convicted of a crime he didn't commit. Why? Because an eyewitness got it wrong. And this is why we need police identification procedures that enhance eyewitness identification accuracy. Great strides have been made in the UK. No longer does a petrified victim have to edge nervously along a row of villains and then cautiously tap one on the shoulder. These days, most police lineups are conducted electronically. This means the witness is shown an image of the suspect, along with similar images of people who physically resemble the suspect. And their job is to reduce the likelihood that the witness just picks a suspect by chance alone. And these current procedures are guided by a vast amount of psychological research. But there's one procedure that's not currently research-led, and that's where my PhD comes in. Now, have a cheeky little look at the person next to you. Have they got any distinguishing features or marks? Surprisingly, over one third of all suspects do. Tattoos, beards, scars, black eyes, gold teeth, I mean, the list goes on. But in a lineup, this causes a problem. If you put a suspect who has a beard, like Frank, in a lineup with people who don't have beards, then the suspect is likely to be selected regardless of whether he is guilty or innocent. This is because the witness isn't using their memories. They're simply picking the only plausible option, the only one with the beard. The question then is this: how can the police construct lineups for distinctive suspects in a way that forces the witness to use their memories? Well, there's two things the police can do to prevent a distinctive suspect from standing out. They can add the feature to the other lineup members, or they can cover up the feature. But you're probably thinking that both of these techniques make it harder for the witness. I did, but I was wrong. I've now tested these procedures in over 17,000 adults spanning from 16 to 95 years of age. And it doesn't seem to matter how you prevent the distinctive suspect from standing out, as long as you do. When these procedures are used, a witness is much less likely to confuse an innocent suspect with the real culprit. If only the police had used these procedures, then perhaps Frank and his beard would not have spent 8 years in prison for a crime he did not commit. Thank you.